Hello, my name is Walter, and welcome back to Luke Cage Season 1, Episode 7. No Flash today, because the Flash is not playing today. It will be for next week. I don't know why. Maybe it's just a delay in their timing. But I will definitely do a reaction of that soon, when it comes out, of course. Now back to Luke Cage. I'm sorry guys, it's been a long time, but I kind of forgot what happened in the last episode. But I believe Luke Cage is kind of like fighting people off or something, just like every time he does it. I'm not really sure, so it'll be nice to have a recap this time, and I hope we do. I think it was him against, I mean, now of course he's exposed himself, and it is definitely him against Mahershala Ali's character, which is Mr. Stokes. So yeah. He's definitely gotten more cocky, man. Oh yeah, Cottonmouth was arrested in the last one. And of course, just like the justice system, it is not perfect. I'm not saying that it's flawed, it's just not perfect. It's not 100%. Like any system, really, like any system at all. It's human error, you know, it's human greed, it's human pride. So oh, fighting words, them's is fighting words, little lady. Well, I mean, they didn't really submit actual evidence against him, so I guess, you know, that's just how the law works, man. You gotta provide cases with like real proofs and like credible sources, everything. Who is this? Is this his mother, or is that somebody new? The intro. Kinda missed the intro. Just with this lengthiness. I'm sorry guys, it is still very lengthy. But I see that they've shed it down 1 minute every time now. And I know I'm late to the party, to finish this. But hey, better late than never, am I right? Of course, Stan Lee is the producer. He made the comic, so it makes sense. I love that it is actually the whole of like Harlem on his body as tattoos. So that's really cool. And I like that he is more of the boxer type. I was about to say too, I thought he was gonna say like Asians, but said Koreans, so. No, his skin is just bulletproof. Proof. Potato, potato. Such tension, such build. His special gun. So like that we see the crown on his head instead of Biggie's. Still love the soundtrack, man. That's true. Ooh. Yeah, but that's a deflection, though. I like that it was a queen in his hand. Is for you, Luke. Am I right? Yep. Hey, that was funny. I'm sorry. Enough. Adiós, muchachos. Was fully expecting that. We'll be in touch. Oh no, he's not gonna say that! Nah, rule number one, man. Rule number one. I knew it, yes. Barney Stinson style. There is always a bigger picture. I love the electronic piano he's playing. The mother has definite issues. I feel sad for Cornell now. Says the woman who cut his finger off. So this is the emotional backstory of Cornell. Why didn't he go to music school then? That's true. Oh, the burns. This is all about the burn game, isn't it? Is that why you don't like the name Button Mark 2? That's true. Oh. But there's more similar than one. Yeah, this is a rhetoric we've seen in Daredevil as well. So he just got blackmailed. Oh man. What if she just like pushes her hand up and manages to slap him? I know that's like super long hand fingers, but Well, I mean, even if you go to prison, you can come back, though. It's true as well. Can run like a bird or a chicken. Do or do not, and the rest I'll try. D nice. So I play on Dennis. I'm guessing that's you. He's a bulldozer, man. He's a frickin' tank. You done? You done fucked up. Nice. Well, he won. She cries dirty. Yeah, it's weird. I think definitely he won't be happy. About Luke Cage taking away the guns of Domingo. He's right, Cornell. Oh, shiz. What just happened? Wait. Oh no. Oh, she's musty. Good question. Well, working outside the law is still kind of a crime. I'm just saying. Yeah, do it, man. What is that? Oh, is it that the special bullet? Somebody found his kryptonite. Somebody found his kryptonite. The reason you guys saw me cry is this one, man. This one finally got me the shit a tear, man. Holy shit. It's because they gave us everything that we needed to form an emotional connection, and I was almost gonna say, well, that's what it did in Daredevil, and that's what made the criminal so much more depth, like had so much depth to him, because he definitely has a history to him why he's like that. And like, I feel so sorry for Cornell now, like, cause like, he didn't technically choose this, and as well as Wilson Fisk. Like, I think like, they're almost on par, but I definitely think Wilson Fisk is more like higher level, because like, he killed his own dad, and then you know, his mom helped him cover it up. But in this one, he didn't choose anything. Like, Mama Mabel forced him to do it. You know, like, he had somewhere else to go. Like, he had talent, musical talent. He had all the tools for him to get out of Harlem and be a better person. And my camera is lagging, and I'm very sorry because it's fucking annoying, I know. But just bear with me for one more minute, please. Like, it's just so sad when it's like, the dynamics change so fast, because like, we all thought that, like, at least I thought that Cornell was the villain. And like, even though I joke like around, like, he's not really intimidating, he does have a sort of, he has sort of the authority to him, that power in his soul. And like, it definitely seems like this is something he did not really want to do, and now we know why he wanted to keep the club up. It's because he loves music so much, and it all makes sense now. And fucking A, man. The sister or whatever, cousin, adoptive cousin, now that we learn about it, she betrayed him and she killed him, man. Oh my god. And now Luke Cage is like super hurt and super down. So it's like, what the fuck, man? What the fuck? Well, I am very late to the party, man. And I guess a lot of people have talked about this episode the most. But with that, I will leave you guys here, and I will see you in the next episode. See you then.